हेलो फ्रेंड्स, माय नेम इज़ सौरभ देशमुख। आई एम वर्किंग एज एन असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग, वॉल्चन इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी, सोलापुर। इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू सॉल्व ए प्रॉब्लम ऑन पेल्टन व्हील टर्बाइन। द लर्निंग आउटकम एट द एंड ऑफ दिस सेशन, द लर्नर विल एबल टू सॉल्व प्रॉब्लम ऑन पेल्टन व्हील टर्बाइन। आई विल रीड द प्रॉब्लम स्टेटमेंट हियर। अ पेल्टन व्हील हैज़ ए मीन बकेट स्पीड ऑफ 10 मीटर पर सेकंड with a jet of water flowing at the rate of 700 liter per second under the head of 30 meters. The buckets deflect the jet through an angle of 160 degree. Calculate the power given by water to runner and the hydraulic efficiency of the turbine. Assume coefficient of viscosity as 0.98. So first of all, we'll write the given data here. Now they have given the speed of the bucket, that is equals to U equals to, it is also U1 equals to U2, is equals to 10 meter per second. Okay, and that bucket is hit by a jet of water flowing at the rate of 700 liters. Okay, so the Q is given here. Q equals to 700 liter per second, which is equals to 0.7 meter cube per second. Okay, now they have also given that the bucket deflects the jet through an angle of 160 degree. So it will be theta equals to 160 degree. So we will calculate phi from it. Phi equals to 180 degree minus 160 degree equals to 20 degree. Also, now they have also given the coefficient of velocity. Okay, so it is denoted by CV equals to 0.98, and they have also given the head, which is H equals to 30 meter. Okay, so we need to calculate the power given by the water to the runner and the hydraulic efficiency of the turbine. So first of all, we will write the formulas here. So it is power given by water to runner equals to, it is rho a v1 into vw1 plus vw2 into u, and the hydraulic efficiency it is given by 2 into VW1 plus VW2 into U by V1 square. So I will just draw a diagram here. So the water will strike here. So this will be the point. This one will be U1. This one will be VR1. And this total velocity will be V1, or we will consider it as a VW1 with no loss. Okay. So now we will just, this water will be deflected by 160 degree. Okay, so I'll just draw it here. This is beta, this is phi, and this will be 160 degrees. Okay, so this will be VR2. This will be V2, this will be VF2, okay, and this will be U2, and this component will be VW2, okay. So first of all, we need to calculate here V1, VW1, VW2. Okay, so we need to calculate these values here. So I will just write the formula for CV, that is coefficient of velocity. So what is the coefficient of velocity? It is CV equals to V1 by square root of 2gh. So what will be V1 here? V1 equals to CV into square root of 2gh, which is equals to 0.98 multiplied by 2 into 9.81 multiplied by 30. So if you substitute these values in the calculator, we will get the solution, the value 23.77 meter per second. Okay, so I will just change the page here. So now we will calculate VW1. So we are considering V1 as VW1 with no loss. Okay, so VW1 equals to V1 equals to we have calculated here V1 23.77. Okay, so it will be 23.77 meter per second. Now we will calculate VW2. So we just need this diagram here. So VW2 equals to what it will be? So VW2, so this component we need to calculate. So it will be VR2 cos phi minus U2. So let's consider VR2 equals to VR1. So what will be VR1 here? VR1 equals to, it will be V1 minus U1. So it will be 23.77 minus 10 equals to 13.77 meter per second. So VR2 equals to VR1 equals to 13.77 meter per second. So now we can calculate the VW2. Okay, so VW2 equals to, we'll substitute the values of VR2, phi and U2. So it will be 13.77 into cos, it is 20 minus U2 is 10. So by calculating in the CALSI, we will get the value 2.94 meter per second. Okay, now we will substitute all this given data into the formulae. So power given by the water, so power given by the water to runner equals to rho a v1 into bracket VW1 plus VW2 into U. So A into V1 is nothing but the discharge, okay, area multiplied by velocity. So it is water, so the density of water will be 1000 multiplied by the discharge is 0.7 into VW1 is 23.77 plus VW2 is 2.94 multiplied by U, it is 10. So after calculating this in the CALSI, we will get the answer here, 186970 watt, or it is 186.97 kilowatt. So for hydraulic efficiency, the formula is 2 into bracket VW1 plus VW2 into U by V1 square. So we'll substitute the values of all these entities. So it will be 2 into 23.77 plus 2.94 into 10 upon V1 square, it is 23.77 square. So after calculating all this in the CALC, we will get it as 0.9454, which is equals to 94.54%. So the power of the turbine is 186.97 kilowatt, and the efficiency, hydraulic efficiency of the turbine will be 94.54%. These are the references. Thank you.